Lekki massacre, more than 10 people killed, soldiers took their bodies away. DJ Switch. Hello everyone, welcome back to Greenfeed Media. I want to thank you especially for taking your time to listen to us and following us. May God bless you in everything that you do. Please like this post and share with your friends. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe. Let us know what you think in the comment section below and may God continue to bless you. Now let's get back to this story on the Lekki massacre. Nigerian artist DJ Switch, who was present when soldiers shot at peaceful protesters in Lekki, in Lagos on a Tuesday, has shared her experience. The artist said armed soldiers and police officers shot at her and other peaceful NSAS protesters at the Lekki toll gate on Tuesday. She said at least 15 people were killed in the shootings and that she and other survivors took the bodies to the soldiers who took them away. Quoting DJ Switch, "Something I think about in inside that I wished we hadn't done was that we carried dead bodies and dropped them at the feet of the soldiers when I asked their unit commander why they are killing us. I wished we hadn't done that because they ended up throwing the bodies in their vans," she said in a video she posted on social media. She also displayed some bullets she recovered from the scene of the shooting. The attack on the unarmed protesters occurred hours after the Lagos state government imposed a curfew in Lagos. The protesters continued their sitting despite the announcement of curfew, which was to start by 9 p.m. on Tuesday. The shooting started before 9 p.m., with the celebrity live streaming the protests and the shootings until she could not continue. DJ Switch statement appears the clearest explanation yet from a witness about what happened in Lekki. It also seeks to clarify the claims that there was no shooting because bodies of victims could not be found. The army denied shooting at the protesters despite contrary evidence, and Governor Sanwo-Olu has also admitted that two people died from the shooting. The governor has promised an investigation while President Muhammadu Buhari has kept mum about the Lekki shooting. The military reports to the president and the governor has said he never authorized the deployment of the soldiers. Amnesty International has said that at least 12 people were killed on Tuesday in both Alausa and Lekki tollgate. The Lekki shooting has been condemned by many Nigerians and members of the international community, including the US government. Quoting DJ Switch on social media, "Yes, there were soldiers, but the other part that people are not talking about is that SARS, the police, also came some 40 to 45 minutes after the soldiers left. We were tear gassed. It was like Cotonou pepper mixed with acid. People were running. We would run. We would come back. The only thing we fought with was our flags. We sat on the floor waving our flags and singing the national anthem. That was all we had. They turned off the street lights. Even if there is no power on a good day on that axis, there is always light on a good day. There was no light. The street lights were off. It was pitch black. A boy jumped on me and was shouting, 'Cover her, cover her.' I didn't even understand why he did that. They shot that boy on my back. I fell. And while the soldiers were running around and trying to pick up their shells, the protesters were also picking shells. These are some of the shells we picked. The military were there on Nigerian soil, killing Nigerian citizens. The SARS came aiming and shooting live bullets at us. Who takes live bullets to a protest? The leaders I urged not to insult the intelligence of Nigerians and their families. Please, I never said 78 people died. When I was doing the live broadcast or the live streaming, 7 had died. After my phone died, we had 15. I don't know if there were more than that, but we had a lot of people with stray bullet wounds. I condemn the burning of buses, and I'm definitely going to come back and be on the street protesting peacefully. We must continue. If we stopped, I fear it must be 60 years before we can do something again." Maybe that's what she means. We need accountability that is at the heart of this matter. We must speak. Do not give up. End of quote. So that was DJ Switch, who live streamed the whole massacre on social media on Tuesday night. It was just something out of a bad movie. In fact, I'm sure most people that watched the live streaming on IG were also crying. It was just evil. So she has explained everything, that after she she was live streaming and her battery died. By then, 7 people had died. After her battery died, and maybe they did the count, they had like 15 people dead. That she never said it was 78 people that died. Something she also mentioned that was more revealing, because I'm sure by then her battery had died, was that after the soldiers had left, 40 to 45 minutes later, SARS came. The police officers that were being protested against came and started shooting at them again using tear gas. No one even knew of that until she put out this statement. May God help us. So please let us know what you think about this story in the comment section. Thank you again for listening to us. We hope you're staying safe out there. And God bless you. Thank you again for listening.